That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
The spherical cover on Antenna 1 at Raisting Earth Station has been reaching up into the sky in Bavaria since 1963. In February 2020, a powerful storm named Bianca, which produced wind speeds of over 160 kilometers per hour, crossed large parts of southern Germany. The air dome over the radome has a surface area of 5,300 square meters and fell victim to the winter storm. The radome achieved fame due to its being used to broadcast the moon landing in June 1969. The television signal was transmitted from the NASA Center in Houston by satellite to Reisting, from where it was broadcast to Europe. Crane rental company BKL won the order to replace the cover. The company used its new LTM 1650-8.1 for the job. An LTM 1230-5.1 was used as the auxiliary crane. When just unfolding the cover on the ground, weak gusts of wind demonstrated just what a massive surface area the diaphragm had. Work started in thick fog at 5 a.m. There was not a breath of wind. Just before sunrise, the giant white diaphragm rose off the ground and was snapped tightly over the antenna. After 18 months, the radome finally had its protective cover back in place. Welcome to the second edition of UpLoad in 2022. Large cranes, which support repair work or install infrastructure, help to change our world sustainably. Large cranes are needed to expand renewables. One of them is our new LR1700-1.0. The very first of which was delivered last summer. This crane model is now in use all over the world. And of course, it's very much at home at wind farms. The first 700-ton crawler crane made its debut at the Holzhausen wind farm near Paderborn in summer 2020. It was fitted with a 165-meter main boom, with 9 slightly wider, heavy version lattice boom sections below it, each measuring 12 meters in length. This means it's able to operate in higher wind speeds, which reduces downtimes. Wind speeds of up to 11.2 meters per second are actually possible for all our current LR crane models, which feature the special wind power setup configurations. This value can even be increased to 13.4 meters per second with very minimal reductions in maximum lifting capacity. The detachable Variotray derrick ballast and the V-frame enable the whole of the turbine to be erected with just 60 tons of derrick ballast, saving time-consuming ballasting work. The large ballast pallet is only required to raise and lower the lattice boom. This is a process that involves just 4 bolts and places a total of 375 tons of counterweights suspended on the derrick boom. The LR1700-1.0 dealt with the complete wind turbine with a hub height of 164 meters with consummate ease. Modern crawler cranes have become used to delivering top performance with jibs. 100 tons or more to a height of 160 meters have become standard hoists for wind power jobs and are a typical requirement for our crawler cranes. Roland, how do we get these jibs to work for us?
For heavy hoisting work in industrial jobs, we typically use luffing jibs. But fixed jibs also have a role to play for these jobs. For example, we can work with a fixed jib if the job involves projecting edges. But of course, the main area of use for fixed jibs is erecting wind turbines.
So that means that as wind turbines continue to get ever higher and ever heavier, using fixed jibs on lattice boom cranes is becoming more and more important. You could say that they've become almost essential for these jobs, as they generate the required space from the main boom and then also deliver greater lifting capacity and hoist height. Is that right?
It certainly is. For example, let's look at the LR11000 with the F2, which generates a fantastic lifting capacity of 253 tons. Parallel operation was also required for this. and it is this parallel operation which then opens up additional possibilities. We can see that here. The pulley sets can be drawn further apart so as to prevent the hook block being twisted. But we have adopted these developments elsewhere for the development of the new LR11000 and then for the LR1800 and LR1700.
Does that mean there are similarities between our crawler cranes for wind power?
The first one involves their maximum lifting capacities. They are 170 tons for the LR1700-1.0 and 185 tons for the LR1800-1.0. Furthermore, 3-meter sections can be used to deliver even more opportunities for users to make improvements. They mean that 3-meter, 6-meter and 12-meter intermediate sections are available. The second point is that the angles of the luffing jibs have been improved. In other words, surface areas are defined for the load, which are then taken into account in the setup so that we can move the boom very close to various components, such as the gondola, to create special benefits for the erection process. And the third point is that the weight of the fixed jib has been improved, of course. In other words, various points have been worked out to erect the long booms, and then all the special conditions must be taken into account, for example, with guying in this case.
Great, Roland. Thanks very much for your insights into jibs. And talking about pushing the envelope with jibs for wind turbines, let's now take a look at the Østerild wind farm in Denmark. Østerild is one of the windiest places in Denmark, and manufacturers of wind turbines have been testing their new developments for generating power at sea there since 2012. Also commonly known as offshore windmills, 9 test fields are currently filled with various different systems, all of them an impressive size. And of course, it's much easier to test new turbines on land than at sea. On field 7, a wind turbine with a capacity of 14 megawatts and a tower height of 155 meters is currently being erected for Siemens Gamesa. 2 equally massive crawler cranes have arrived to install what is to date the largest turbine at Østerild. 2 Liebherr LR11350 cranes set up for a hook height of 185 meters. Each crane is equipped with the power boom and 380 tons of ballast. That enables them to hoist gross loads of around 350 tons to the top of the 154 meter tower. This also looks massive, the 10 meter high gondola. It has a gigantic volume of 800 cubic meters. The largest load case among the components for the colossal turbine for the 2 hoisting machines from Liebherr, however, is by far the massive generator. Including the hook blocks, special yoke and fastening equipment, each crane has a gross load of 176 tons. 100 of these turbines have been earmarked for the Sofia wind farm in the English North Sea. That's why they're currently being tested on land. There are plans to install these turbines with a rotor diameter of 222 meters in the North Sea as from 2024. To ensure that the cranes we deliver to our customers can be used expertly and correctly, trained personnel are required on both sides. Particularly during the pandemic, however, it's been difficult to fly halfway around the world and then provide training courses quickly. Our customer service team reacted to this and introduced virtual training courses and crane handovers together with our local branches and customers. For example, an LTM 1650-8.1 was handed over in Japan together with virtual training for this ultimate machine on 8 axles.
The biggest challenge was the equipment and integrating the whole thing into our system so we could communicate with people. We also need a stable, high-speed internet connection for the job. Some of the items require the use of several cameras. We solved the problem in such a way that we positioned a camera on top of the roof that gave us a view of everything that was going on. And we also placed a helmet camera on an engineer on site with a microphone and a small speaker that allowed us to communicate. Of course, handovers do not generally take place on a beautiful, tidy yard like the one at our branch office, but often have to be completed at wind farms, on building sites, or at refineries. And these places often have poor data networks. Cameras and mobile phones are banned, so of course the whole thing is impossible. The time difference with some countries can also be a problem. Here in Japan, they are 7 hours ahead of us. As the handover cannot take place in the dark, it means we simply have to get up earlier. At the same time, digitalization will also help us with troubleshooting work. There is no longer any need to travel to South America because of a blown fuse. Staying close to our customers is very important to us. We want the customer to be with us at the handover so we can explain everything in person. That is one of our basic values, but it is something that is simply not possible in the digital world.
While at the beginning of this broadcast we were all looking into space, we're currently achieving completely new altitudes with a new mobile crane, and have even set a new world record with the LTM 1300-6.3. Franz, what makes this all-terrain crane a record-breaking crane?
Quite simply, it's the boom. For the very first time, we have built a crane which can carry a 90-meter boom on public roads, with an axle load of under 12 tons.
A 90-meter boom on six axles? How's that possible?
The boom has been designed using our time-tested concept. It consists of a pivot section and a total of seven telescopic sections. That's one telescopic section more than the LTM 1300-6.2 has, for example. We have managed to reduce the weight all over the crane by a wide range of detailed improvements. For example, the undercarriage on the LTM 1300-6.3 has a particularly efficient design. That meant that we were able to reinforce the load-bearing parts and also extend the boom length. This smart, lightweight design is the result of many years of experience and new findings we've made in construction, structural engineering, and also in our suppliers' structural steel production methods. All these factors have been brought together to achieve this.
What else does the new six-axle crane offer?
Well, it has the Vario Base Plus, for which the rear outriggers can be extended further than the front ones. And then it has the familiar Vario Ballast and also Auto Ballast, which makes picking up the counterweight significantly easier. So we could say that this crane has all the new technologies.
Fantastic. Thanks very much, Franz. Another important point we should mention is that the new LTM 1300-6.3 is not actually replacing a crane, but is simply an additional machine in our six-axle segment. This crane has the longest, most powerful telescopic boom in the segment, and therefore remains a fast erecting crane. The LTM 1300-6.2, on the other hand, is our alternative luffing jib crane. If you need any further advice, please don't hesitate to contact our sales team. And that brings us to the end for today. But we'll soon be seeing each other again, when we'll be inspecting a very quiet crane job. All the best, and see you soon.